Here's our little chickens. We just got the food from inside the coop. I'm gonna miss my chickens. They're so cool. So nice to have chickens. I love them. But this is an update of our chicken coop. We used for about a year. We are selling our coop for a family that needs chickens. And we're gonna take the whole thing. We're gonna take the chicken coop and the chickens, everything. Our food, the straw, everything, the air supplies, their heating lamps, and my father-in-law is here to help us. This is 14 feet tall. You can see there's a sliding door, and you has chicken wire on it. You open the door, you slide it open like that. Then you get inside. This is the area where we can put the food and the water, and in rainy days they stay here safe. And there's something like too much wind or tornado watches, that's where they come. They come to their little shelter. And this is a very nice because we can hang the feeders here. Over here you can see there's another sliding door. This is not completely closed, but you can see very resistant to any type of weather. It's not too hot, not too cold. It's like the temperature is really good inside here. Very easy to clean. We're gonna spray some water here. You're gonna see how it's gonna be clean. That's where they sleep. We did not have a rooster. Because we did not have a rooster, our eggs are not fertilized, and we didn't have intention to have little chicks. That's why their nesting boxes are higher. But if you're planning to have baby chicks, it's just better to be on the level, the ground level, because when the baby chicks are born, they can't jump that high, obviously. So for us, this works pretty good if it's just for eggs and no chicks. But if you're planning to have chicks, then I would suggest to put in the ground level. So these are some of the eggs. I already collected some today. You can see some of the eggs. So here, it's dusty because, you know, chickens everywhere has dust. So you open the lid and there's like food over here. And then over here is their trash. Like every time that nest is like something dirty, poop or something, when you need to change the... some egg broke by accident or something, you change replace the straw so they don't smell the egg, or they don't... so they don't eat their own eggs. And the heating lamp, and then some of the extra food in here, and that straw, like this alfalfa. That's their feeder water, but this water they don't like very much. They like that one better. And another feeder over there. They use this full about every 2 days. You need to fill it up, and they do that, complain a lot when you're around. Kind of like they want to let us know, they want us to give them food. We have 20 chickens. We bought 25 chickens last year, but last year we had some chickens that died. One was a little baby and she got out and couldn't go back, and I think she died of cold. And we got her alive, but she only lasted for a few minutes, and I tried to survive her, but she didn't make it. And then I had two chickens that one of them got sick and died with a parasite or something. The other chicken got a bite of something, I'm not sure what was it, and she died. I had another two chickens. One of them was a hawk that came and killed it, and the other one just died by no reason. Like, I just found her dead, and it was like she looked healthy and everything, but suddenly died. So from the 25 chickens, we have 20 chickens right now exactly. They all seem to be healthy. They all lay a lot of eggs. They are just wonderful. If you're considering have chickens, I would highly recommend it. If you have a backyard, they're just fun, and they're just so nice for the little kids to have a little animal. But anyways, it's is our baby here. Say hi. 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 It is 5:30 right now, and we're still not done because this is a whole day project. So right now, Daniel is washing the chicken coop.
You don't want to get wet anymore?
No, he can't be more wet than what he's already.
It's not so much about it being so heavy, it is heavy, but just having it buckle under its own weight while lifting it, when it's not sitting flat on the ground, is a real challenge. But we did it, and it's bending, you know, and we're lifting it up. But we got it up there completely without a single bend.
You got wet? How did that happen? How did that happen? How did you get wet?
Well, we're gonna end up the vlog here. I hope you enjoyed our adventure with this update of our chicken coop, and we'll see you guys next time. Bye bye. Say bye.
Bye.
Bye bye.
No.
You got all wet, didn't you?